Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, I thank you. Everlasting Father, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, we appreciate you. Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Holy Spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let us begin to thank God. Let us begin to appreciate him for everything that he has done in our life. Begin to thank him. Begin to appreciate him. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. Begin to thank him. Begin to thank this God. Begin to appreciate him. Let us begin to appreciate him right now. Let us begin to thank him for what he's doing right now and what he's going to do. Begin to thank him. Begin to thank him. Begin to appreciate him in the mighty name of Jesus. Please share and invite your friends to come. Please begin to share. Begin to invite your friend to join us. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to share. Begin to share. Let people know that we are going to be blessed today. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, you are worthy to be praised. The I am that I am, the beginning to the end. Father, Lord, we appreciate you. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to appreciate him for today. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to thank him. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we appreciate you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you for everything that you are doing right now. We thank you for what you are going to do. Oh, Baba, we thank you. Jesus Christ, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you for a great thing that is going to do in our life. We thank you for what you are doing right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we love you. Holy Spirit, we love you. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to thank him. Let us begin to appreciate him for today. Let us begin to thank him for the strength that he has given to us. Let us begin to thank him. Father, Lord, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we thank you for our life, for the life of our children, for the life of our friends. I thank you, Lord, for the life of everyone here in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I thank you for disappointing all the works of the enemies against our life. Father, Lord, we thank you. We appreciate you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank him where you are right now. Begin to thank him. Begin to appreciate him. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you. We appreciate you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you, Sister Obi. God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Almighty God will reward you for everything that you have been doing here. Sister Ahumensin, God will surely bless you. Brother Kelly, God will bless you. Victor Enina, God will bless you. If I don't mention your name, don't take it personal. God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Brown, God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Begin to thank God. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to thank him. Thank him. Praise his name the way David praised the name of the Lord. Father, Lord, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we thank you, Jesus, for making it happen that we are here today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for the week, O Lord. Father, Lord, we thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to appreciate him. Begin to thank him. Thank him in advance. Thank you for what he has done for you before. Thank you for what you are doing right now. Father, Lord, we thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Holy Spirit, I thank you, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. I just want to put this music so that we can use it. Father, Lord, we thank you, Jesus. Makaraba city, ribaba shandarabu kuto ribobo city, ribaba katalaba city, ribobo shindere, re katazindo ribobo city. Father, Lord, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I thank you for shouting the mouth of the lions against me. Rebobo zindaraba kata, re kata kata zindaraba. Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost. Oh, Father, Lord, I cover everyone here with the blood of Jesus. I cover their children with the blood of Jesus. I cover their environment with the blood of Jesus. I cover everything that concerns them with the blood of Jesus. I cover their environment with the blood of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, King of Kings. Father, Lord, let them receive today. Let them receive your blessings today. Father, Lord, open their eyes to receive today in the mighty name of Jesus. I bind every tutorial spirit right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every prayer collectors, I cancel, I renounce right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, have your way today. Holy Spirit, have your way today in the mighty name of Jesus. Have your way today, oh Lord. We are open to receive from you. We are open to receive from you, Holy Spirit. Have your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, touch us today. Holy Spirit, touch us today. Father, Lord, open the eyes of our understanding today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, everything that we want to say today, oh Lord, Father, Lord, let us understand, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, don't let us go back the same way we came, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Holy Spirit, we thank you. Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you for this month. We thank you what you are going to do after. Father, Lord, we thank you for all these physical and spiritual battles that you have been fighting for us. Oh, Baba, we appreciate you in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Baba, touch us. Begin to pray. Begin to thank him. Begin to thank him because he's going to do wonders in your life this week from today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you for the prophetic word that you're going to use today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I pray for myself. Father, Lord, see through me today. Father, Lord, speak through my voice today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, Holy Spirit, have your way in my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way in my life today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. I just want to welcome you all today for coming to this fasting and the prayer deliverance today. I just want to thank you and God will surely bless you for joining in. Please share this video and let everybody see it. And invite your friends, invite everybody to come and join. Today is day 13 of our 40 days and fasting prayer. And God will surely bless all of you for this time. God will bless you for taking your time to do this fasting for yourself, for taking this extra mile for yourself. God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us thank him before we go to the word now. Let us begin to thank him. Thank him for what he's doing. Begin to thank him. Begin to thank him. Begin to appreciate this God. Father, Lord, we appreciate you, oh Lord. We appreciate you from day one, oh God. Father, Lord, we appreciate you. Father, Lord, we thank you because you are God in our life. Father, Lord, you are number one in our life. Father, Lord, thank you for making every impossibility to be possible in our life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, thank you for blessing our career. Thank you, Lord. We are here today, oh Lord. Father, Lord, it's your will, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, open the doors of heavens upon us. Father, Lord, bless us beyond our imagination in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we cover this prayer line with the blood of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen and amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I love you all. I love everybody. And God love you more in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. So today is day 13 of the fasting and praying we are doing. I like to do it every week, like doing every day, I mean. But some people, they are going to work because of the activities that they are doing every day. But we are still sending prayer points on our WhatsApp group. We have WhatsApp group. We post our prayers and everything. We have other pastors there and everything. So we decided to be doing it Saturday and Sunday. I might come online tomorrow and, you know, according to how the Holy Spirit leads. I just want to welcome you all. For those of you that just coming for the first time, and my name is Prophetess Dora Agresi. I live here in Edmonton, Canada. If you read the post here, if you have any prayer point, there's a number there below. I have my Canada number there and WhatsApp prayer group. If you want to join more prayer, you want to be on more fire, we have the number is there. You can just come in and let us pray for you. So I'm just going to read Isaiah 22:22, which says, "And the keys of the house of David will I lay upon his shoulder, so he shall open and none shall shut, and he shall shut and none shall open." Because today we are going to break every spiritual padlock, Every padlock that have been holding our destiny, we're going to break it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Any padlock, wherever they have locked anyone's destiny here, today, because we are here, Almighty God, we break it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked your destiny, the destiny of your children, your career, your business, but because you are here today, you will not go back the same way you came in the mighty name of Jesus. So let us begin to pray. Let us begin to say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, wherever my destiny has been locked down, Holy Spirit, Father, Lord, open it. Father, Lord, locate it. Wherever my destiny has been locked, Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's use that one to start. Father, Lord, open it. Open every padlock that I've been used to lock down my destiny. Father, Lord, open it. Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. You know which area you feel that you are not manifesting. Begin to pray for God to open it. Wherever they have locked it, begin to pray. Begin to say, Father, Lord, open it. Wherever it is, you know where the area that you are not manifesting, begin to pray that, Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, concerning this area, Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever I'm not manifesting, Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm going to repeat that verse again so that we know where we are going. That's Isaiah 22:22, which says, and the key of the house of David will I lay upon his shoulder, so he shall open and none shall shut, and he shall shut, none shall open. You see, what the Bible verse is saying here, it says we give you the key of house of David, you know. So we're going to talk about more about key and the padlock today, which is very interesting. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That's what we're going to talk about today, so that you will know when you are praying and how you're going to direct your prayers. Because when you are praying, don't know the strategic prayer that you're going to pray. You are just like somebody that is just going around there in one circle. So that is the reason I want to, you know, preach and let people to know, explain it and where we are going, so that when you pray, you know what you are praying about. Because this is a deliverance ministry, I need to teach you how to pray and how to go about things when things are going on in your life. So I'm going to read Revelation 3:7, and the angel of the church in Philadelphia write the words of the Holy One, the true one, who has the key of David, who opens and no one will shut, who shuts and no one will open. You see, because God is the one that is going to open it. When you give your life to God, you will see that every door that have been shut in your life, Holy Spirit will open it in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray for someone here, whatever doors that have been shut in your life, whether it's your career, your business, your destiny, whatever they have shut in your life spiritually, because you are here today, makarabo, reba, basinda, raba, shetekereba, fire of the Holy Ghost, begin to move and touch anyone here, that any area of their life that has been locked, open it, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. As your word said, that we just read now, that you are the only one that have that key that can open any doors. Father, Lord, open the doors that have been shut against anyone here, good doors that have been shut. Father, Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, lock every evil door that is not good in their life, that is giving them problem. Father, Lord, lock it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. I just want to quickly thank people, welcome people again, people that are here. Thank God a lot of people are here today early. Mommy Abubakar, God bless you. Brother Jerry, God bless you. Brother Wellington, God bless you. Brother Omoro Giver, God bless you. Great man of God, Brother Jerry Woman, God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Brother Kelly, God bless you. Melody Brown, God will surely bless you. Don't worry, I'm coming to your show. I'm still on it with you. God will surely bless you, great man of God. Thank you for all the, because this man that I'm talking about is a gospel singer. When he sing, heaven will come down. In case if anybody need who, any gospel musician that wants to sing, he is very anointed. When I say anointed, he is highly anointed. He lives here in Edmonton. Sister Juliet Obasuhan, God will surely bless you. ID Bude, God will bless you. Prophetess Florence Coco from South Africa, God will surely bless you. Great man of God, my cousin Alessi Hammer, God will bless you. And I love you for all the good work that you are doing. God will bless you for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, if I don't mention your name, don't take it personal. And God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. For the people that are just coming in now, we are just praying we are praying a bad key, you know, we are praying a bad padlock, because a lot of people, their things have been padlocked for a long time. That's why they are going on around the one circle. So I'm going to teach you today, open your eyes today, so that you will know what is going on and how you will pray, how you will direct the prayer, sir. Mm-hmm. So, you know, in heaven, key is very, very important in heaven. You know this key, like that Revelation and the book of Isaiah that I just read, you know, key is very, very important in heaven. And in the spiritual realm, padlock is very, very important, especially the witchcraft kingdom or Tasmarine kingdom. Padlock is very, very important to them. So that is the reason why they take it seriously. But in heaven, key is something that, you know, when heaven will open the doors for you, things will begin to flow. But Satan was in heaven before his fall. You know, he know all those things that God is using to bless us. That's why he's using it against us. So you see, in heaven, our key is very, very important. But in spiritual realm, padlock and key is very, very important. They lock it down. When they're locking down, the person will just be going around and going around and going around. We are going to pray many prayer points today. So just take your paper and pen. I'm going to post the prayer point to our WhatsApp group. If you request it, you are not a WhatsApp group, and I encourage you to come, because lots of pastors are there. So you will see, because we're going to pray a lot of prayer, because this is a praying ministry. So we're not going to be talking too much. We pray, we have praised God. So like I said, in the spiritual realm, is where padlock is very, very important to them. They take it very seriously. You know, lots of people don't believe it, or they have lost everything. They don't believe that all those things exist. You know, in Africa, where we are coming from, Satan, you know, demons, they are raw over there. They are raw. But over here in Overseas, where we are, demons, they wear coats, they wear tie. You don't really recognize them. Uh-huh. That's why they are operating more here. You understand me? Uh-huh. So over in Africa, there's church here. People, because of work and all that, they don't really go to work. You understand? So we are going to talk more about padlock today. I'm going to open your eyes and with a prayer point. You know, padlock, it's a lock. You know, padlock is something like when you have a padlock. Now, for example, I wanted to bring padlock, I forgot. You know, padlock, when you use it to lock something, it stops access. You understand me? You know, when they lock something now, it stops for you to get access to something. You understand me? Then it restrain movement. You understand me? For example, now they padlock something, you can't go inside there. You can't take anything from inside there. So everything will be locked down. You understand? Padlock lock things. You know, when they lock it in the spiritual world, for example, they lock somebody's destiny, the person's destiny cannot go because they have locked it. So people will just lock it. You know, people are really wicked. You know, it's time for us. You know, people say, it's not good to be spiritual. It's good to be spiritual all the time. You understand me? Uh-huh. So padlock in a spiritual work, like I said, if they lock down the person's destiny, or they lock down the children's destiny, you see that people, if the person will just be going around. You see a lot of people, they are doctors, they are this, they are that, they cannot really do much. You understand me? Because that destiny has been locked down. You know, some people, they can lock down their finances. You know, the most wicked one, they will go and throw it in the river. It's Holy Spirit, you know, the eyes of fire of God that will go and locate it where they throw it in the river. Uh-huh. So it takes higher anointing to retrieve it and break it and ban whatever they are doing. You know, example, you know, like marriages can be locked. Marriages can be locked with padlock. Destinies, like I said earlier, can be locked. And the finances can be locked. And your academic career can be locked. Businesses can be locked. Job can be locked. You know, spiritual life can be locked too. You understand me? Uh-huh. So you see some people, they are looking for a job. Look. That job, people will apply today, they will get, but they will not get. Some people's business are just crumbling because somebody has locked it everywhere. You see some people now, their health-wise, they can still lock it down. Some people now, their career, different things, you know, they lock it down. But if we're like, you have to know the battle that you are fighting. When you are praying, like I said, know the strategic prayer that you will be praying. Not that you pray here, you don't really know what you are praying about. So without padlock, there will never be a key. So without that padlock, there will never be a key. You know, I just want to pray for you too, because you are here today in the mighty name of Jesus. That key of her house of David that we just read, you will get it in the mighty name of Jesus. You will get that house, the key, that key of David, you will get it. You will have access to get it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever, anything they have locked in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus, those things you will get it today in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, some people's hearts are locked. When you are telling them good things, good advice about themselves, they don't take. They take the one that devil is telling them. They have already banned their mind. They have already locked their mind. I pray that anyone here that have that kind of mind, Almighty God will change you today, because God is the one that touches the heart of the king. He turns it wherever he wishes to. You understand me? Some people's ears are locked. You know, when things have happened, their eye will now come and open, because he has locked down spiritually. Some eyes are locked too, because some people, they don't dream. I've seen when some people say they don't dream, I'm kind of like, really? So they don't dream. Some people, they don't really dream, because everything has been locked down. You understand me? So some people, they have locked down their healing. You know, instead of them to receive their healing, they will not be receiving it. They'll say his hand, his leg. Doctor will be giving all different kind of evil reports. There was one time here in Canada when I was sick. So when I was sick, so this doctor here that is an Edmonton, is a very big doctor. Say a lot of people, they when that doctor says something, he has said it. So when that doctor told me, oh, 3 months ago, no, that I just said, doctor, I said, look, I said, that is your own report. God have my own report. It's the report of God that I'm going to believe. I begin to pray. I say, whatever sickness, whatever arrow of sickness, wherever they want to lock me down, I command it now to be broken in the mighty name of Jesus. I begin to pray. When I started praying, then I went to another doctor. So this doctor said, she's an elderly woman. I said, okay, we'll just check it and see. What that woman, she said, okay, it's there. I told God, I said, whatever that you have not planted in my body, Father, Lord, remove it in the mighty name of Jesus. Remove it in the mighty name of Jesus. But when we got there, everything was just like this. Nothing happened at all. But if I was dwelling in that, I would say, oh, God, why me? Oh, Father, why is it now? I'm a minister, so I want to. If people hear that I'm sick now, those are sentiment prayers. Heaven don't listen to sentiment prayers. When you really pray, you know what you are talking about, then you will not get heaven attention. So some people now, they lock their destiny, they lock their testimony. Their testimony will never come to them. You know, they can lock somebody's body system. You see some people now, they are not dead, but they are just walking corpse. If you see, they say, what is wrong with this one? They have already, everything in their life, they have already locked it down. You know, padlock is a powerful tool in a demonic world. It's very, very powerful. But people, they don't understand, because people, they have stayed long in the white man's land, so they just feel that all those things are not happening. Hey, I'm telling you, it's happening, because here that you are, you have to pray without ceasing, and a lot of things are happening. And like I said, the demon here, they wear coat, they operate more here in abroad here, so we have to be careful. My auntie is here. God bless you, ma. God bless you. My mom, sister, she's our mom. Now, God bless you, ma. So, that is what we are praying for. And like I said, in a spiritual realm, it's very, very important. But in God's kingdom, it's very, very important. When heaven has open everything that they have given to you, you will see that your life will begin to manifest. But in a demonic world, they turn it around, they reverse it so that they can use it to punish people. You know, in spiritual realm, key is a revelation and wisdom. You understand me? That is in a spiritual realm. Key is a revelation and wisdom. If a key is locked from, if you dream now, for example, you see that people are locking things. They are locking things. You have to wake up. Bandit first, like what I always tell people, bandit first before you can run to your pastor. Because your pastor might be on the air, then you want to wait for a pastor. You bond it first, then you know that you are in a serious trouble, like really trouble. You understand me? So when you are sleeping, you wake up, you pray, you bond it. You know that the evil one, they are locking down your things. They are locking down your destiny. God will bless me, the Abubakar and the mommy, Deborah. So you see that they have locked that. You have to pray seriously, because if it happens like that, they have already locked in that. So God is telling you now to pray so that you can scatter the works of the evil hands. Or you dream that you are in a warehouse. It was last year. This sister, she has a ministry. She was just going around in her ministry. Please share this video. Share it and invite your friend, and God will surely bless you. So this sister, she was just going around the ministry. She's not doing anything. She doesn't even have a paper. She have been in a, she have been in America for so many years, like really so many years. She don't have a husband. She don't have money. Just count how many things she don't have. No husband, no money, no document, career. She doesn't have any career. Her ministry is not working. But when God just opened my eyes, I saw this sister. This sister was inside a warehouse. Her things was there, and other people's things were still in the warehouse. She was just in the warehouse. She could not pack. She could not pack any of her things. They were trying to push her out of that warehouse so that she cannot touch this. No, when she tried to, when she was trying to take her things from there, so they were pushing her out. When they push her, she finally climbed down. That's another error again. She finally climbed down from that step because it's a very big house. So she now climbed down. Instead of, when somebody dream that you will climb a step, or okay, God is blessing you. But she now climbed down from the warehouse. Then she go. When she go, then God opened my eyes again. That warehouse is surrounded. The gateman they have in that warehouse is serpent. And there was a very big serpent that was on the side. This serpent was laying another X. It was laying X to bring more children to the world. You understand me? So this sister, she's in trouble, like really, really trouble. She's in really, really trouble. So I told her, I said, we're going to pray. If you want to pray, it doesn't mean because you are a woman of God, God cannot show you something, it will show another person. So we have to pray. So we started praying and praying and praying and praying and praying and praying and praying. Then things begin to go well for this sister. So we need to pray that serpent, the serpent that have laid that egg, that is bringing more demons to the world, we have to pray that God will destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray this prayer right now that every serpent they have sent to go and be guiding whatever belongs to you, spiritual serpent they have sent that is still laying another new egg. They want to recruit more of them. We're going to pray this minute that Almighty God will cut off their head in the mighty name of Jesus. Because God has defeated that serpent in the cross of Calvary. You have crushed the head of that serpent. So we're going to pray right now. I want to pull 1 minute. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, every spiritual serpent they have sent to be guiding my things spiritually, command them to be executed now. Command their head to be bruised now. Command their head to be cut off now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Actually, serpent can swallow people. It can swallow people's destiny. We put it on the belly. Let us begin to pray now. Whatever that evil serpent has swallowed, it should vomit it and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray for Almighty God to set that serpent on fire in the mighty name of Jesus. You that evil serpent, I command your head to be cut off right now. Begin to command that serpent that they have sent against your destiny. That serpent they have sent to be guiding your things in an evil warehouse. Begin to pray right now that serpent will be electrocuted right now. Makarabo soto reba basinta rabaye. Begin to pray now. Every spiritual serpent that is guiding your properties spiritually, begin to tell that serpent to receive fire right now. Every ex that the serpent is slain right now, that ex now, command that ex now to be electrocuted right now. I release fire of the Almighty God. I release fire of Almighty God. I release fire of Almighty God. I release fire of Almighty God upon you right now. Be electrocuted. Be electrocuted. Begin to pray. Makarabose teteri baba shandarba. Holy Ghost, locate that serpent. Locate that serpent in the mighty name of Jesus. Because some people, they don't believe on spiritual things. That's why they are still where they are today. By the time you don't believe, it doesn't mean. That person, you see, say people that say it doesn't matter. That is another spirit of it doesn't matter. Every time I used to preach it to people, if you see people that know me, they know spirit of it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I'm in abroad. Okay, we're in abroad. Even the Bible even said it. Serpent, he will creep in. When he will creep in, we come and hide. When he hide, but when it is time for the serpent to strike, he will strike. That time, the serpent has struck the person on his or her own guarded hour. So we will not let that one happen. You understand me? We will not let it happen. We have to pray with that season. We pray because when, if you see people, all those satanic demons, they are very serious of what they are doing. They carry the assignment seriously. But where did the children child of God. We don't go to God the way Satan are going to you know, to report on God, because the Bible did not say that Satan is not going to see God. Satan is still going there. God will ask him, what are you doing? He say, I'm going around looking for who to divorce. So we will not let them to divorce us. Like I said, if you see, you find yourself in a warehouse, you have to pray harder, because all your inheritance have been locked down there. You understand me? And if you see that somebody put your things in a car, he's driving it away, you are, know that you are in a, like, really serious trouble. Trust me. You understand me? Or you see that great doors, you stand now, doors have been locking. They have been locking. You know, God can just help. Like I said, some people, they don't dream. When they dream, they don't remember. You have to pray that you have to dream, because anything happen, God will give you the revelation. And when everything is revealed, it's going to be redeemed. You understand me? So when you see that, they lock that place, they lock it, you need to pray. You need to pray very hard. You know that they are busy locking your assets, busy locking your things in the spiritual realm. That's why you have to pray. Pray first, then you now call the pastor. That's the way things are supposed to be. So it takes the higher anointing, the power of God, to break that door, so that you can have that key of the house of David. So when we're talking about the key of house of David, when heaven gives you the key of house of David, you are blessed. You are blessed. All those, you know, all those are spiritual things that you need to know. So I'm going to shock you. I'm going to, show you more things now before we're going to pray. Like I said, join our WhatsApp prayer group. There you will see all prayers there. If you want to replay the video. So that key of house of David, it means a lot. Father Lord, give me the house of key of David. I want someone here to pray right now. Say, Father Lord, give me the key of house of David in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm praying for myself. Father Lord, give me the key of house of David in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, give me the key of house of David. Holy Spirit, give me the key of house of David in the mighty name of Jesus. But when you have that key, you can open any spiritual doors, that is going to bless you, and you can still use that key to lock every evil doors that the enemies has opened for you. You know, key is an instrument used to lock and open doors. You understand me? If a door was locked, it is only a person that hold the key that can open it. For example, the door is locked now, it's you that have the key that will open the door. You understand me? So I want your eyes to be open today, so that, like I said earlier, you know what, how you're going to be praying. So no matter how or experienced you are, if your house door is locked and you did not have a key, you cannot enter. And from there, bad things, a lot of things can be meeting you there. You see some people now, the enemy have locked them spiritually, outside. Good thing never reached them, because the destiny has been locked. That's why you see that some people, good things never meet them. You know, before the good things reach there, something will happen, they will never get it. They have already locked everything down. So, like I said, you will remain outside until something will come and happen before, except you get the key. But some people, they say they want to break the key. You can break the key, like some pastor, like this ministry, we don't do breaking of keys and everything. We talk to Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is the one that is going to take charge, that is going to do it. I'm not going to tell anybody, bring padlock, and then, no. It's Holy Spirit that is going to do it. Some pastors said, people, bring key, and they will break it. I don't think that works. It will not work. It's Holy Spirit that is going to locate it. For example, they lock somebody's destiny and put it in the river. Then pastor will come and tell you, bring key, let's open it. let us use our own discretion to, sometimes when they are giving you a vision, prophetic vision, we have to use our own mind to know what we are doing. So when they do, everything is spiritual. So don't ever let somebody say, go and bring a key, they have locked it, I want to open it. All those are just, it won't work. You understand? It's not going to last. I will tell you why it's not going to last very soon. So to get your possession, to get everything that they have locked in the warehouse, you need that spiritual key to open it, to get it. It's only God that have that key that's going to make you to open those doors. And it's God that's going to shut every evil doors against you and open the good door in your life. For example, our inheritance are in heaven. In another word, the headquarters of our inheritance and possessions and heaven. So our possessions and inheritance and heaven. That's why some people now, because like I said, Satan, he was in heaven. You know, he was loved. He was loved in heaven. But everything just locked down because, you know, they locked him out of heaven. You see, Satan was locked out of heaven. He was loved there. Then when he come, everything that he learned in heaven, so he now reverse it, so that he can use it to come and be punishing the children of God. If you read Malachi 3:10, and most of these possessions had been released to us. You see, he said, and most of these possessions has been released to us. He doesn't say it's taken from us. But the enemies hijacked them and keep them in their own warehouse here on earth. Let me repeat that one again, because everything that I'm preaching here is in the Bible. Malachi 3:10, and most of these possessions has been released to us, but the enemies hijacked them and keep them in their own warehouse here on earth. So the enemy now is the one that hijack it. So God has given us, he has telling us, go and take dominion, take everything. But the enemy now are not taking it from us. They not put it in their own spiritual warehouse and hijack. You see that everything that is happening, heaven already, they already mapped this world. They already know what is happening, right? I just want to honor a great prophetess here, prophetess Igihon. God will bless you, man. I love you, man. God will bless you for turning in today. We really appreciate you. So I'm going to read 1 Samuel 30:18. And David recovered all that the Amalekites had carried away, and David rescued his two wives. You see, David is a man that know what he really want. So he take all the things that they have taken from him, including his wife, he rescued. But some people, if you are telling them to pray, you are telling them even to say amen, their mouth will make pop. Your mouth, like if you say amen, amen is Jesus, that means you receive, because whatever we are doing is spiritual, because all those things have to be received in heaven. Then heaven now will not release it to you, then everything will start to manifest. That's when you say amen, heaven receive it. But when you don't say amen, and you are not too sure, you are not key, bad luck, are they lucky things? Bad luck, and I'm not too sure. I don't think that one is happening. I don't think that kind of thing is happening. Why are you saying that? You know, people that are saying that, who don't believe things are happening, they are the people that are spending 100 years in another man's land. People that believe, that want to pray, you see that their destiny is just moving. Things are just moving for them. So, So you just see that things are really moving for them. So I've read that for someone. So I pray for you, so that you shall recover everything, every of your destiny that the enemy has locked down in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, I shall recover. I shall overtake whatever the enemy has locked down in the mighty name of Jesus. My career, my business, my destiny, my marriage, whatever you see that the enemy has locked down in your life. You know, just begin to claim it now. Begin to claim it by fire, by force. Begin to claim it. Say, whatever the enemies have locked down in my life, I claim it in the mighty name of Jesus. I claim it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever they have taken from me, I claim it. Whatever of my things that is in the warehouse of Satan, I collect it back. Begin to collect it back. It's good for you to live spiritual. Don't ever think, oh, it's not happening, God will do it. When you say God will do it, you are not praying. And people that know that God is doing it, and they are praying, they are bombarding the heaven. So you sit down there and say, for example, now, okay, let me make this example. For example, your husband is not here. You are sitting down. Say, oh, I love my husband. Is he hearing? He's not hearing. It's because he's not there. You have to talk. You have to have relationship with this husband, or relationship with this your daughter or your son. That's how the person will know that, oh, he said he loved me. He loved me. So when you are sitting down, you are saying God will do it, and you are not praying to God, they don't hear it. They will not hear it at all. It's not, it's that one. That is just the reality. You understand me? So you pray so that heaven will get your attention. So inside the warehouse of enemies, many Christians' possessions, inside that warehouse, many Christians' possessions, property, destiny, spouse, glory, ministry, many things have been locked down there to stop their progress. You know, Today is the day I want you to release, you know, realize, sorry. Today is the day I want you to realize who you are and how devil has cheated you away from your inheritance. How devil have cheated you away from everything that God has given you. How devil has removed you from the place, locked you out from the place that you are going to have your inheritance to possess your possession. So you're going to pray like this. Anywhere that I supposed to have my take a possession, dominion, and the Satan has taken me away from there, Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, open it. Open it for me in the mighty name of Jesus. Open it for me in the mighty name of Jesus. Because some people, they are just somewhere. That place has been locked. Satan has locked that place for them, and things are not happening for them. So I'm going to tell you, but we're talking about pastors. He's saying that they bring padlock. He want to open the padlock. He's opening it now. No, because why some things are not working, or maybe they pray some, when they pray for somebody, the thing will just work for some time because they have negotiated. You know, like this ministry, we don't negotiate because they have negotiated with Satan. You understand me? So Satan will just give, okay, don't worry, I will just let the person stay for 3 months or 1 year. After 1 year, all those things, they're going to collect it back from you. So when they say, bring padlock, let them break it. It's a lie. It's not going to happen because it's Holy Spirit that is going to locate that padlock wherever they put it with the eyes of fire and destroy it. You understand me? So for example, if someone's destiny is locked with 7 padlocks, listen to this one very well. When somebody destiny is locked with 7 padlock, you know, if one padlock is open, the problem still remains because you must open those 7 padlock. They use you see the, because Satan is very, very cunning. So when they lock at 7 places, because people are really wicked, you understand me? He said the heart of man is desperately wicked. They lock it with 7 padlock. You go and meet a pastor that is negotiating. So this pastor now open one. What about the 6? So that is what I'm trying to say here, because when Holy Spirit opening, Holy Spirit open the 7 padlock at once. The Holy Spirit will not open one and leave one. You understand me? So if you see this 7, number 7 in the spiritual realm, number 7 called numbers. Alphabet is very, very important in the spiritual realm, more than important. That numbers, alphabet, all those is very, very important. In the Bible, numbers are very, very important, because I cannot just explain. If we can continue to explain it today, we're not going to live here. Like I said, numbers and alphabet is very important in the spiritual realm. So if you see this number 7, this number 7 is a number of completeness and perfection. Number 7, that's what number 7 means, because different numbers have different meanings. Imagine somebody that have locked that person with 7 padlock, so that person will never be complete in his life. You see the trick, how devil reverse it, how devil change it. So that person will never be complete in his or her life. So anything that person do will never be perfect, will never complete. You understand me? We never be complete. The person will be doing something half. So you see the trick now, because number 7 in a God word, in God's kingdom, is completeness and perfection. So if you dream of number 7, it's completeness and perfection. So Satan now, they now change it. So when they lock somebody, like all those churches, we know the church we are talking about, I don't want to mention them. So all those churches, they light 7 candles. They like 7, this one, 7, this one. We have to be careful. So like I said, 7 means completeness and perfection. So that person, it will be doing something half. Nothing will ever complete on that person is doing. So that is what that 7 padlocks that they used to lock down the person, that is what it means. You understand me? So they don't just carry and go and be locking it. They are doing it according to how their father, Satan, teach them. You understand me? So like 5, they lock somebody. I'm not going to say all numbers, just few numbers for you to get, you know, idea of what I'm explaining. Like number 5 now, they lock somebody destiny. They just lock the person, everything with 5 padlock. You see, like number 5 now is God's grace, goodness and favor.
So if you don't have God's grace, I don't know how the person is going to walk in life. That's why you see somebody, they will be having bad luck and bad luck. You see this number 5, they don't look and say, bam, okay, this person is getting luck too much. That's why you have to close your mouth. Don't be saying your progress to people anyhow. You understand me? So when you are saying your progress anyhow, you talk. They don't have to ask you questions. The person that is with you, he thinks that's your best friend. The person is a friendly friend, doesn't want good things for you. So they can lock the person down with 5 padlock. So when they lock the person down with 5 padlock, so in the Bible, we dream, like, you know, Holy Spirit show you the number of 5. That means God has given you that garment of grace. That means goodness and favor will follow you. God will anoint your head with the oil of favor. You understand? And goodness, that is what it means. But when they lock it up, so in that reverse, the person will never get favor. The grace of God will never work for the person. The mercy of God will never work for the person. The person will struggle and struggle. Where everybody is receiving favor, that person will not receive favor from there. You understand me? So if I say I want to continue preaching, we will not go. You understand me? I will just stop for the preaching so that we start to bombard the heaven. So you see how this number means. We have to know what this number means. That's why I just put this numbers. You see, some people now, they say they have locked them down 3 times with 3 padlocks, and locked them 1. They have locked them 7. They have, you know, so all those ones have a meaning in the tour ring. God will bless you, Brother Kester. God will bless everyone here in Jesus' name. You know, it's only God and with fasting and praying with a higher anointing, like I said, can unlock it. So about bringing padlock and other things, bring chain, they have chained you, come and do it. All those things, go out from there. It's not going to work. All those people, there are people that are negotiating with the evil one, because it's God that is going to release you spiritually. You understand me? You don't have to break any chain. You don't have to go and be buying padlock for what? You understand me? You know, some children are locked down. You know, some three, amen. God is the devil. God punish the devil, mommy. You know, in Jesus' name. You know, some children are locked down. You know, that is the reason, you see, some people that they just have 5 boys. Those 5 boys, they are, you know, they have great destiny. They'll just lock them down. You see, rapists will be there. The one that is sick will be sick. The one that is thief will be stealing. You know, everything will just be happening. The woman will be running, hey, is this pastor? Bring padlock. Is this pastor? Bring chain. Is this pastor? Bring this one. No, when a man of God pray for you with olive oil, you know, God will go. Because when God created this world, I just want to bring that one in. So God know, just to tell you that all those things is wrong. That's why this is my prayer, and this is my platform. People, they really want to come and teach here. But I don't want them to come and be selling things. No, that is not the way God was. When this world, you know, before the fall of Satan, there was still darkness everywhere. You understand me? There were darkness everywhere. So when we were discussing that Jesus Christ will come, and everything, and Satan, they don't allow Satan to enter the meeting anymore. So he begins jealous. So some of his people that were moving with him are some demons. He has a whole group now in heaven. So all those ones now, they throw them down along with him, because they don't want to leave anyone there. So when God go down, you know, our God, his eyes is fire. Our God, he go down, look down. When he looked down, he see the throne that we're sitting in darkness. He saw the principalities that were sitting in darkness over there. You understand me? So it's only God. Me and you, we cannot see it. It's only God that will see it. When they do it, they go and meet all those churches or all those people that use water. They go and throw things in the river. So that padlock that they bring will not really do much for you. It's bringing more problem. Because when they negotiate, they're going to take something from me. It's only God that will go there. You know, go there. Deep his mighty hand. This is right hand that is power. Deep it there. Bring the padlock. Destroy it. That is how it's supposed to be. So padlock is a limitation. So when they lock somebody up with padlock, it's a limitation. You understand me? So that is what I'm trying to explain to you. So don't let people do that to you. You pray and Holy Spirit will surely set you free in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, Jesus is the only one that had the keys that can open the doors in earth and heaven. No matter where the enemy has kept your possessions. You understand me? The keys to open and unlock is with Jesus. You know, because the power is already given to him. So that's why you have to give your life to God. You know what you are doing when you do it, because Jesus already have that key. So if you read Bible, read down very well. When Jesus rise, he go to the pit of hell, he go and collect that key. That is the key we are talking about. That key of David, went to go and collect it. So he is the one that is going to open it. So bringing padlock and bringing chains to come and be breaking the church, it's not going to help anything. So you see the spiritual, you see the spiritual talk now. So Jesus Christ rise on that third day, went to the pit of hell, collect that key from Satan, and he came back. He came back. That is just the right thing to do. You understand me? Or go and be taking shower in the river and all those things. All those things you are having, putting more problem upon problem. Like they say in my country, say, why by here? You carry more problem and come and put it, you put Kenny on top of Kenny, you are drawing it again. So that is very wrong. And I'm going to read the Matthew 28:18, which says, and God came and spoke unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. You see, so this power is God that have this power, not you. So I'm going to read there. Not all those people that say bring padlock. That padlock, they will even lock it one more against you. So be careful. So Revelation 3:7, and to the angel of the church in Philadelphia, write, this thing says, he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens, no man can shut, and shut, no man can open. You see now, so we're going to start prayer right now. So get ready. We're going to start prayer. Before we start now, we're going to pray just a short prayer. Then we start praying right now. And God will surely bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I'm going to start to bombard the heaven. Father, Lord, because they are here today with the anointing and the grace upon my head. Father, Lord, whatever that they have locked down in their life, whether finances, whether the career, whether in a health-wise, whatever, womb, whatever they have locked down, Father, Lord, open it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, begin to touch them in the mighty name of Jesus. The one that need a perfect job, Father, Lord, give it to them in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for every padlock that has been hindering your blessing. That is the first prayer we're going to pray today. So we're going to be like fast because of our time. But we're going to finish all the prayer today. All the prayer points will be on WhatsApp prayer group for today and fasting. So we want to pray for every power, every padlock they have been using to hinder your destiny, that is making you to be going around in one circle. Say, every power using padlock to hinder my destiny, catch fire now and die. I'm going to be putting now. You see, every power using padlock to hinder my blessings, catch fire now and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power using padlock to hinder my blessing, catch fire now and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power using padlock to hinder my destiny, catch fire now and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that is using padlock to hinder my destiny, I command you now to break in the mighty name of Jesus. Catch fire now, catch fire now, catch fire now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power using padlock to hinder my blessings, sir, I command you now to catch fire. I command you now to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Catch fire now, catch fire now, catch fire now, catch fire now in the mighty name of Jesus, sir. Every padlock they are using to hinder my destiny, I command you now to catch fire. I command you now to catch fire. I command you now to catch fire. I command you now to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're still going to pray against womb. The lock womb, it doesn't mean that the lock womb for you not to have a baby. They can lock womb so that they will be depositing a lot of things in that womb. I had a revelation. I said it before. This revelation, I see that they line up women. When they line up these women, they have hospital there. This is spiritually I'm talking about. They have hospital there. So the women were coming down. So when the women go, they'll put them on that table. When they put the woman on that table, they would be putting different things on her womb. That is where you see a lot of people, they have fibroid, they have this, they have, the womb is not just locked. Then if you tell somebody that is pregnant, then there's something must happen. They'll say, ah, because he have fibro, because he have this one, the womb has been locked down. You understand me? But there was one woman there who was prayerful. They were passing the woman, passing. I was staying there. I was looking at them. So that is what is happening. Some people now, they just threw away their womb. They put a lot of things. A lot of things has been deposited there. All those things are just things to disguise. It's a tactic for Satan to say, oh, it's because the womb is locked. The fallopian tube is not good. That's why it's not having baby. Those are the tactics. They have locked the womb. So we're going to pray. Say, every household power using padlock to lock up my womb. It is time to let my womb go. In the mighty name of Jesus, every household wickedness that use padlock to lock my womb, it is time to let me go. Oh, Father, Lord, open my womb by fire. Father, Lord, open my womb by fire. Father, Lord, sanitize my womb by fire. Holy Spirit, sanitize my womb by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to pray for Holy Spirit to sanitize your womb. Some people, they don't even have children again. They have given birth to all their children, but they still have problem in that womb. So we're going to pray to them. Holy Spirit, sanitize my womb. Holy Spirit, sanitize my womb in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, sanitize my womb. Sanitize my womb in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever deposit they have used, they have deposited inside my womb. Holy Spirit, sanitize my womb. Sanitize my womb in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for every power that are assigned to lock down your marriage. You know, some people, they are married. Their marriage is just everywhere. They are not enjoying their marriage. Their marriage is just going from one place to another. They don't enjoy it. They have locked it down that you will never enjoy your marriage. You understand me? Because marriage is to enjoy, not to endure. Because a lot of people now, they are enjoying marriage. They are enjoying. That is not how God designed it. God said a man should love his wife as Christ loved the church. The woman be submissive to your wife, submissive to your husband. So it's an order, you know, it's what God said. But some people, they, if they do her, say, their husband don't even know whether they do her. They have to go and tell their husband. Don't you see this cap that I just put for my head? Don't you see I just go to salon because the husband is not there. So we're going to pray. Every wicked personality assigned to locked my marriage, die now in the mighty name of Jesus. Because every prayer we're going to be praying today is going to be now. It's going to be happen now. That is the kind of prayer we're going to be praying. So every padlock that I've used to lock down my marriage, I command you now to break now in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray that padlock that they have used to lock down your marriage, that you will break now so that you will enjoy that marriage. Because it's your right to enjoy your marriage. So that's the prayer I want you to pray now. We're just going to put like 5 seconds. So every personality assigned to lock down my marriage, I command you to break now. I command you to break now in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever principalities and powers in the high places that have locked down my marriage, that is not making me to enjoy my marriage, I command you now to receive fire. I command you now to receive fire. I command you now to receive fire in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're still going to pray for, we're going to pray the next prayer for destiny that has been locked down. We have to pray for God to open it today by fire. Whatever destiny that has been locked down, we're going to pray for God to open it. If it is your child destiny, you feel that it has been locked, or your business, whatever you feel that has been locked down in your life. So I want you to pray, say, every padlock used to lock up my destiny, you must open today in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever padlock they have used to lock down my destiny, I command you now to open. I command you now to open in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked down my destiny with a padlock, I command you now to open. I command you now to open. Begin to decree and declare now that every padlock that they have used to lock down your destiny shall open right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked down my destiny, oh Father Lord, open it. Father Lord, open it. Father Lord, open it. Father Lord, open it. In the mighty name of Jesus, wherever you feel that they have locked, whether it's a business, whether it's a career, whether it's marriage, whether it's your children, whether it's your husband or your wife, whatever you know, begin to pray right now. Say, Father Lord, open it. Father Lord, open it. A lot of testimonies are coming. You understand? So, Father Lord, open it. open it, what wherever they have locked my destiny, that because that your destiny is you, that your destiny is what you will use in life. Understand? So begin to pray, Father Lord, open it wherever they have locked down my destiny. Father Lord, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Like I said, don't go about and let people be giving you padlock. They want to use the padlock to open it. Like I said, number seven, like when they lock somebody padlock with seven. So how that person is going to progress. So we have to be careful about that. So we're going to pray for this one. We're going to pray, say, like ancestral padlock. You know, they have ancestral padlock. So this ancestral padlock, they use it because the family now, because there's a power, things that happen when you were not there. You know, things that happen when you were not there. So they have locked down everyone in that family. So we're going to pray today. I'm going to give 1 minute for you to pray wherever you are right now. Say, ancestral padlock, used to lock up my business, used to lock up my marriage, my wife, used to lock everything, my career, anything. Begin to break it now. Every ancestral padlock, pray it with holy mindedness. Begin to pray. Say, every ancestral padlock, used to lock so. In your life, begin to pray it right now. Ancestral padlock, that is a very wicked one. Ancestral padlock is very wicked because they have locked every family, everybody in that family. Because if you see now, it will now become a partner, a pattern. It's not a pattern now. Say, every ancestral padlocker, I command you now to break open in the mighty name of Jesus. Every ancestral padlocker, they have used to lock so and so. They have used to lock my finances, my destiny, my marriage, anything that concerns me, my children, my womb, my health. I break it now. I break it now with the power of the Holy Ghost. I break it now. I break it now. Ancestral padlocker, I break you now. I break you now. I break you now. I break you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to remove yourself from that ancestral padlocker. Begin to remove yourself. Remove your children. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. In the mighty name of Jesus, every ancestral padlock, I break it now. Begin to break it. Begin to break every ancestral padlocker. Begin to break it. Say, I break you now. I break you now. I break you now. I break you now in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to break it, begin to break it, begin to break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray right now. We're going to pray, say, every padlock of stagnation, of limitation in my life, every padlock of limitation in my life, I'm going to pray for God to begin to break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of limitation, every padlock that have made me to be stagnant in one place, Father Lord, I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of limitation, I break it now. Begin to break it. That padlock of limitation, they have used to lock you down in one place. Begin to break it in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, King of Kings, every padlock they have used to lock anyone destiny here, whatever they have locked in their life, Holy Spirit, you are the only one that is going to open it. It's not me, it's not there. Father Lord, open it. Holy Spirit, open it in the mighty name of Jesus. That's the padlock they have used to make them stagnant in one place. Oh, Father Lord, locate it and break it. Holy Spirit, locate it and break it. Father Lord, locate it and break it in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray. There's another padlock of untimely death. This one is another one. Like I said, devil have a way of using his own tactics to be disorganized, doing things for people. You know, the person, they have already, some things have already happened. They have already killed the person. Once you just hear the person, you just make bam like this. It's already finished. So we're going to break every padlock of a timely debtor in the mighty name of Jesus. They have locked it that the person will die, like when I was talking about numbers earlier. You know, so the person will die on the 30th of this one. The person will die on the 15th of this one. They have already marked it on their evil calendar. So we're going to break it. Every padlock of a timely debt, break now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of untimely death, break by fire. Break now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of untimely death, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Break in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of untimely death, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Break now. Begin to pray. Every padlock of untimely death, Begin to break it now. Begin to break it now by the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, Lord, every padlock of untimely death, I break it now. I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. Every padlock of untimely death, I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that I have written any data and put it in a padlock, I lock it. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray this one very well. Every padlock of untimely death, I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of untimely death is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray this one. This one, this is an invisible padlock. Like I said, it's not physical padlock that you are seeing here. You understand me? It's a spiritual padlock they have used to lock every of your assets. Begin to pray for God to break it. Whatever invisible padlock they have used to lock your assets, they have used to lock your progress, begin to tell God to break it to pieces now. Father Lord, we break it. Father Lord, we break it. Holy Spirit, we break it. You break it by fire. We break it right now. 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 We break it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. So the one we just read in the book of Revelation. So we're going to pray now for God to give us that key of David to open that place that they have locked. Like I said, that key will lock, because if there's no padlock, there will be no key. So we're going to pray right now for God to give us that key of the house of David so that spiritually all the good doors that have been locked will be opened in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, I use the key of David to open every padlock I ignorantly used to lock every area of my life. Because some people, they still use their own hand to lock their progress. They use to, you know, ignorantly they use their hand to lock it. So we're gonna pray. I use the key of David to open every padlock that I ignorantly used to lock every area of my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Because some people, they are the one just lock their life. When you are going around doing things that is not of God, you are the person is just locking his own destiny by himself. So let us begin to pray. I use the key of the house of David to open every padlock that I ignorantly use to lock every area of my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Tell God to give you that key of house of David to use to open every door that you have opened ignorantly for yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray right now for God to open every gate they have locked against you. You know, when they push the person spiritually, some people, they are in a cage, but they are walking up and down here. They are walking. I will pray for people in the video. We are praying now because this is a serious, you know, we are praying now. So when you need prayer, I'll just give 1 minute so that you can come in and I'll pray for you. So some people, they are in a cage. So as they are in that cage, so yeah, the demon now, the spiritual demon will go there, put the person in a cage, lock it with spiritual padlock. So look at it. Picture is in a normal life. When somebody is in a prison, here, when the person in a prison, how the person will move. You cannot move from that prison, except the police will come and open the door for the prison door for the person to move, to come out. So we're going to pray, say, I command every evil padlock used to lock up my gates and doors of favor to break and scatter now in the mighty name of Jesus. I command every evil padlock used to lock up my gates and doors of favor to open now in the mighty name of Jesus. So begin to pray. I command that every evil padlock used to lock up my gate of destiny, my gate of favor in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray now. Begin to pray now to scatter right now, to open right now. The Holy Spirit will open it for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock they have used to lock up the gate of your doors and favor, that Holy Spirit will open it right now. That Holy Spirit will open it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil padlock they have used to lock every gate of your favor, Holy Spirit will open it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked you down, wherever every cage they have locked you down spiritually, and Satan is holding the key, Ah, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, open it now. Holy Spirit, open it now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every spiritual gate, Holy Spirit, open it now. Holy Spirit, open it now. Holy Spirit, you are the only one that have the key. Holy Spirit, open it now. In the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for every evil part, Lord, that they have used to lock up your money, finances. So when you see some people now, they are just going from debt to debt. They are just going from debt to debt everywhere because their finances have been locked. Let me tell you one story about one sister. You know this sister, it's all those people, they never know. You know when they sponsor them there to Italy, right? So the one, they use them to swear something. You understand me? So if you see now, when they go there, if they don't pay that money, their hand has already been tied somewhere. Or some people, out of jealousy, wickedness, they will tie the person's hand. So this sister, now when she paid the money, her hand started scratching her, and hand started scratching her, her hand started scratching her, her hand started scratching her. So you see that they have locked the money down. Or you see some people, they have been making a lot of money. So you see that the things we started shaking and shaking and shaking. So that money has been locked down in satanic warehouse. So we're going to pray. We're going to pray right now with holy madness and say, I command every evil padlock used to lock up my money and in an evil bank to break. Whatever your money that has been locked down on evil banker, begin to tell God to break it right now. Because when that evil bank is broken, all your business will enter. All your assets that they have seized will come. You will not be paying debt that you don't know. You will not be going from debt to debt. You will not be borrowing money. Because all that satanic banker, they have been depositing your money spiritually that they used that padlock to lock. Tell God now to open it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, every evil padlock that have been used to lock up my money in an evil banker, in a demonic banker, Father, Lord, break it. Holy Spirit, break it. Father, Lord, break it. Begin to tell God to break it right now. Begin to tell God to break that satanic banker. They have locked down your money. They have locked down your assets, your finances in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, I command every evil padlock that have been used to lock up my money in the evil bank in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, break that banker. Father, Lord, break that banker. Holy Spirit, break that banker. Father, Lord, break that banker. Begin to pray. Maybe that's the reason why your business is not going. Maybe that is the reason you are not finding a good job. Because when you find a good job, you did a good business, things will begin to work for you. One time I had a revelation. When somebody, you want to get a check. Somebody know about this thing that I'm talking now. When somebody wants to get a check, somebody will come and collect the check. When some person want to climb a ladder, that same person will come and cut the person down from that ladder spiritually. When the person want to enter a big house, a very fine mansion, the person will come and tell the person, oh, come and go this place, come and go this place. When the person has said, you have to pray because this person is your problem. Like me now, I don't get revelation. They say, the person use another person cover face. No, once you are coming, you want to come and do your evil things, Almighty God will naked you. I will see the real person that is coming. You understand me? So if you dream that kind of a dream, they are collecting your check or you are going climbing ladder, somebody bring you down, you have to pray because there is trouble. You understand me? God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for... I'm going to pray right now for God now to break every evil carpenter that is used, when they name it. You saw those padlock, they name it. They close it. When they name it, they close it. When they name it, they close it. So we're going to pray for God to destroy it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic carpenter using evil padlock to waste my projects, business goals, dreams, marriage, job, career to be destroyed right now in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for that satanic carpenter to die right now. Every satanic carpenter that I've been used to lock down my destiny, my business, begin to pray right now. Makaraba Sete, Rebo Bozen Daraba. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, every satanic carpenter that they have used to nail and lock my progress, I command them now to receive fire. I command them now to receive fire. I command them now to receive fire. I command them not 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 to receive fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to command them not to receive fire. Begin to command them not to receive fire. Begin to command them not to receive fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray this one, because a lot of people, they are going from month to month, from day to day, they are just struggling. They are just struggling everywhere. Nothing is good, because they have done it that they will never better. That is the one that we are talking, that they have already went and throw them in the river. They have already go and throw them in the sea. So we want to pray, Lord, with the key of David in your hands, I unlock my daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly blessings now. In the mighty name of Jesus, if you are blessed for the whole year, there is no problem, because people that are blessed for the whole year, they don't have horns in their head. They are still praying. So why not you be blessed for the whole year? Every day you are blessed. Every week you are blessed. Every month you are blessed. You understand me? Year to year you are blessed. So we're going to pray. Say, Father Lord, with the key of the house of David in your hands, Lord, I unlock all my daily, weekly, monthly, year blessings right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Know that when you are blessed today, next month something is happening, the other month something is happening. Say, Lord, with the key of the house of David in your hands, I unlock my daily, my weekly, my monthly, my yearly blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray right now. Begin to pray that you will be blessed throughout the year. You will be blessed every day. You will be blessed every minute. You will be blessed every second in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, I will be blessed every minute. I will be blessed every second. I will be blessed every year in the mighty name of Jesus. My destiny will never be locked down. My destiny will never be locked down, because I will be blessed every year, every day, every second of my life in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray right now that Almighty God, that every witchcraft padlock that they have used to lock you permanently, because there are some people, like they have locked them permanently. Like what I said earlier, they just do it and lock it and put it in a river, or go and dig it in the ground, in a bush. You know, sometimes what the people are doing, they will close their eyes, they will go and dig it in a bush, they leave it there. So we're going to pray that wherever they have locked you down permanently, that Almighty God will release you today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, wherever they have locked everyone here permanently, they have concluded that person's case. Now that person have locked that permanently. Father Lord, locate it and set them free. Father Lord, locate it and set them free. Holy Spirit, locate them and set them free. Wherever they have locked them down permanently. Oh, Baba, Father Lord, locate it and set them free. Locate it and set them free in the mighty name of Jesus. Someone needs to pray this prayer here. Wherever they have locked me down permanently, Father Lord, locate it and set me free. Holy Spirit, locate it and set me free. In the mighty name of Jesus, every permanent padlocker they have used to locate, they lock me down permanently, they have concluded my case. Father Lord, release me. Father Lord, release me. Father Lord, release me. Father Lord, release me. Holy Spirit, release me. Release me, Lord. Father Lord, release me. Wherever my case has been concluded in a spiritual arena, they say they will lock me forever. They will lock me permanently. Father Lord, release me. I release myself. 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 Begin to release yourself right now. Begin to release yourself right now. Wherever they have locked you down permanently, I have released myself. I have released myself. I release myself. I release myself in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray this one. Say, I open the padlock. Oh God, cause my prophetic doors to open now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every door God has, you know, open for me, Father Lord, let it open right now in the mighty name of Jesus. As I open the padlock, oh God, cause my prophetic doors of favor to open for me right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to decree and declare to yourself, because there's a prophetic doors that will open for someone here today in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray for that God should open that prophetic door for you that prophetic door that God will open it for you, the door that will open for you that no man will shut. Begin to tell God to open it for you. Begin to tell God to open it for you. Begin to tell God to open that door for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, that prophetic doors that no man can shut. Father, Lord, open it for me. Father, Lord, open it for me. Begin to tell God to open that prophetic door for you. Tell God to open it for you. Because when God opened that door for you, people will think that you did something. You did not do anything because God has opened that door for you prophetically. No man can change it. In the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray for you now, every doors, good doors that God has opened for you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, that door, oh Lord, will open forever in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil doors that they have opened, oh God, Father, Lord, close it. Father, Lord, close it. Father, Lord, close it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever door that you have opened for them prophetically, oh door, oh Lord, Father, Lord, let that door be open forever. Let that door be open forever. Let that door be open forever. Let more good doors be open for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we thank you. We want to pray for someone here, some people that having difficulty in their marital destiny. We want to pray for God to connect them to the rightful spouse in the mighty name of Jesus. Not the spouse that will cheat them, not the spouse that have been connecting them to the wrong people. So I know some people here are married, but let us join faith together and pray for our sisters and brothers that are trusting God for good marriage in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I say, I open the padlock. Oh God, cause my marital destiny to open. Connect me with my spouse and cause my marital story to change this year in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for everyone here that are trusting God for marital breakthrough, whether you are a man or a woman. Almighty God will make you to locate that your spouse right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power that is connecting you to wrong people, I command that power now to lose their hold in the mighty name of Jesus. Your story will change maritally this year. I say your story will change maritally this year in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked down your marital destiny, in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are here today, is broken, 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 is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked down your marital destiny, I command it now to be open. 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 I command it now to be open in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're gonna pray this prayer. I know some people, they are falling for different trouble. When one trouble is finished, they have not finished that trouble, another trouble will come. Because when they open that padlock, they put more fire, they close it, many problems will be coming. So we're going to pray, say, padlock of darkness causing me troubles, break and release me now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of darkness that is causing me troubles, break and release me now. Break and release me now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock of darkness that is causing me trouble, that is giving more trouble upon trouble. You know, some people, instead of blessing will be meeting blessing in their hand, it's trouble that is meeting troubles in their hand. So every padlock of darkness that is causing me trouble, I command you to break. I command you to break. I command you to break in the mighty name of Jesus. I command you to break in the mighty name of Jesus. So the next one, I'm going to pray for any padlock that has been responsible for your failure, sir, and setback in life. Say, Father, Lord, evil padlock responsible for my failures in life, expire now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil padlock that is responsible for my failure, I command you now to expire in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil padlock that is responsible for my failure, I command you now to break by fire, break by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Every evil padlock that is causing failure in your life, command it now to expire today. Command it now to expire today, because you are destined to rise and shine. You are destined to rise and shine. You are to be like a lamp that is light on top of the hill that can never be broke, that can never be covered. So begin to pray. Every padlock that is responsible for your failures, that is responsible for your setback, command it now to expire in the mighty name of Jesus. Command it now to be expired. Command it now to be expired in the mighty name of Jesus. Command it now to be expired in the mighty name of Jesus. The big one, we're going to pray for, you know, some people, they are helpers. They have a lot of helpers. but they are not helping them. Even they even have a lot of people that have reached their family, they are not helping them because their destiny helper has been locked down. So we're going to pray. My helpers that have been locked with evil padlock, Father Lord, break them and let them locate me now in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they have locked my destiny helper down, Holy Spirit, locate it and break it now and let them locate me in the mighty name of Jesus. Someone needs to pray it here. Someone needs to pray it because that person have never get a helper. The person have never get a helper. You need to pray right now. Everywhere they have locked down my destiny helper, Father Lord, locate it and break them and let them locate me today in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever evil padlocker they have used to lock down my destiny helper, Father Lord, break it now. 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 Your destiny helper could be your boss at work. Your destiny helper can be your husband, can be your wife. Your destiny, you know, destiny helper come from everywhere. So, Father Lord, wherever they have locked down my destiny helpers, Father Lord, let them begin to locate me now. Father Lord, release them. Father Lord, release them. Holy Spirit, release them. Holy Spirit, release them. Holy Spirit, release them in the mighty name of Jesus. Another big one, some people, they never get a testimony. A lot of people, they are giving testimony, but some people never give a testimony. That's why you see some people, they go to church, and they begin to give fake testimony. It's a sin because they see that everybody around them is getting testimony. They are not getting their own testimony. So it now become a problem. It now become a concern in their life. I pray for you today because you are here today, you will get your testimony. Wherever you need that testimony, that thing that the enemy has been seizing for your life, but because you are here today, that testimony will be released unto you. That testimony will be released unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray that the satanic stronghold holding my testimony, sir, I command you now to lose your hold and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic stronghold that I'll be holding down my testimony, I command you now to lose your hold. I command you now to lose your hold and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic stronghold that I'll be holding down my destiny, I command you now to lose your hold. Lose your hold. Lose your hold right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Because some people, they never give testimony. They never have testimony. They hear people around them have testimony. You know, the Satan will so deal with them that testimony they will not get it. Say, Father Lord, every stronghold that is holding down my testimony, let it release me now. Let it release me now. Let it release me now in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray for this one. We'll soon finish now. Very soon we'll finish. You say we're going to pray this one. Every personality summoning my name into any padlock. You know, when they are mentioning the person's name like this, padlock, they will be conquering it. Conquering, they will mention the person's name. They will be doing evil decree. Whatever is going to happen to the person. Whatever is going to be happen to the person. So we're going to pray this one loud, very loud. Say, every personality summoning my name, sir, my children's name, sir, my husband's name, sir, my business name, sir, into evil padlock, break now in the mighty name of Jesus. I command you now to die in the mighty name of Jesus. I command that evil padlock now to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Every personality summoning my name, sir, into any padlock, I command you now to die. 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 I command you now to die in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil personality summoning my name on evil padlock, I command you not to die. I command you not to die in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, they will just be doing that declaration. They'll just be doing that decree. They'll just be summoning people's name. They will just be saying all kind of things in evil padlock. After they have said it, they will come and lock the padlock and go and keep it somewhere. So begin to pray. Say, every personality that is summoning my name on evil padlock, I command you now to break. I command you now to break. I command you now to break in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray the next one. Say, angel of Lord, go and break any satanic padlock in charge of my case. Like I said, we are going to cover every area today. The prayer point will still be on our WhatsApp prayer group. So we're going to cover every prayer point today so that we move on to the next level for tomorrow. Uh-huh. So it says, angel of God, go and break any satanic padlock in charge in my case. You know, like I said earlier, some people, they use time need them. Like some people, when it is that particular time, the thing want to happen, that is where problem will come. You understand me? because they have, you know, they have done a lot of things on that padlock, so they will not open it now. You understand? Say, angel of the Lord, go and break any satanic padlock in charge of my case. You know, because some people, my next program now will be, my case is urgent. You know, so that person, they now put, you know, they are a satanic word. A lot of people, they are in charge of their case now. This case is a hot case. You know, some people, they have a hot case in a satanic kingdom. You say, this person, you carry this person name, come. This person, you carry this person name, come. Only one person. You understand me? So go to pray this one, holy anger, where you are right now. Say, angel of the living God, go and break any satanic padlock in charge of my case. In the mighty name of Jesus, holy angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. In the mighty name of Jesus, that is where you see the lock, 12 padlock, 15 padlock against somebody, or against somebody's children, or against somebody's business, whatever it is. Say, angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. Now, in the mighty name of Jesus, angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. In the mighty name of Jesus, angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. In the name of Jesus, angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to tell the angel of the living God to break every evil padlock in charge of your case. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen, amen, and amen, and amen, and amen, and amen. Angel of the living God, break every satanic padlock in charge of my case. Break it in the mighty name of Jesus. The next one says, any evil padlock used against me that is in the sea, break and open now in the mighty name of Jesus. Like what I said earlier, when some pastors will tell you, go and bring padlock so that we can open it. Go and bring 5 padlock so that we can open it. All those things are lies. You see, this prayer point that you have just released now, you know, padlock that has been deep in the sea. They have went to drop in an ocean. So that padlock that they are opening, that they had with their hands, how is it going to be open? You understand me? So don't believe all that. Continue to do what is in the Bible. That is how you are going to be saved. You understand me? It's only God. Like I said earlier, when we just started, it's only God that will go and see where that padlock is. Because our God have the eyes of fire. He will locate it and break it. Holy Spirit know what to do with the padlock. Instead of you to go there, Holy Spirit can just go there, or angel of God go there. They just see. They already know where it is. They open it for you. Instead of you to go and meet somebody, they will tell you, go and buy padlock and all this. Don't believe all that. You understand me? So I'm going to pray. My destiny in an evil padlock, come out by fire and locate me now. You understand me? So I'm going to pray. As they do it, they will lock it. Angel of God will lock it. And will lock it in the mighty name of Jesus. So the prayer points go like this. Any evil padlock used against me that is in the sea, break open now in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil padlock used against me that in the sea or any river, wherever river they have thrown it at, break now in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, break it. Begin to tell Holy Spirit to break it. Any evil padlock used against you that they have thrown in the sea, that Holy Spirit will break it now. Holy Spirit will break it now. Holy Spirit will break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil padlock used against you that is in the sea, Holy Spirit will break it now. Locate it and break it. Begin to pray. Holy Spirit, locate it. Wherever any padlock they have used against me, they have thrown in the sea because of wickedness. Holy Spirit, locate it and open it. Locate it and break it. Locate it and open it. Locate it and break it. Locate it and open it. Locate it and break it. Locate it and open it. Locate it and break it in the mighty name of Jesus. So we're going to pray this one. Say, Master Key of Almighty God, open any padlock holding me down in one spot. You see what I'm still saying? You see what I'm still saying? When somebody will say, want to break padlock, they say some people break chain. Want to break that chain. Are you God that is going to break the chain? Don't believe that. Don't believe that. You understand me? So it's God. You see, the Bible verse that I've been reading since. It's God, Holy Spirit, it's God that have that key. Jesus Christ that have that key. After 3 days, he went to the pit of hell and get that key. So it's the one that had that key that will open the door. It's not pastor. It's not me now. It's not me. It's not you. It's him that is going to open that door. So we're going to pray for that master key now to begin to open every door that has been locked against you. Every padlock that have used to lock your destiny, we're going to pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Master Key of Almighty God, open any padlock holding me down in one spot in the mighty name of Jesus. Me, I will pray this one for myself. I don't know about you. Say, Master Key of Almighty God, open any padlock holding me down in one spot in the mighty name of Jesus. Master Key of Almighty God, open any padlock holding me down in one spot. Open that padlock they have used to lock every good thing, my possessions, my inheritance. Open it with that master key, Lord. Oh, Lord, open it. Open it with that master key. Father, Lord, open it with that master key. Oh, Father, Lord, open it with that master key. Holy Spirit, open it with that master key. Father, Lord, open it. Use your master key, that key of the house of David that is with you. Father, Lord, use it. Open the door. Use it to open that padlock in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, you are the one that have the key. Father, Lord, open it. Father, Lord, open it. Father, Lord, open it. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So, one of you all have about four to go. Yeah, one, two, about four to go. Say, padlock of my father's house. Padlock of my father's house enemies that used to lock down the glories of my children and the glory of my family. I break you now in the mighty name of Jesus. So, we're going to pray. I said that one earlier. The padlock of your father's house. Join your mother's house. Say, padlock of my father's house and my mother's house that I've used to lock the glories of the children of that family. I break you now. I break you now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every padlock, evil padlock of my father's house, the wicked elders are using in my father's house, they have used to lock the glories of the children of the family. Command it now to be broken. Command it now to be broken. Separate yourself now. Say, I remove myself. Command it now to be broken. Command it now to be broken. Is this your family? It's just a pattern. Nobody is rich in the family. Nobody is doing every good thing in the family because they have locked the glories of the children of that family down. It doesn't matter when the children are abroad and all. Don't let the devil deceive you. You have to pray. Say, padlock of my father's house and my mother's house, they have used to lock the glory of the children of that family. I break you now. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, that evil padlock in my father's house, or the ones that the evil, wicked elders are using to lock the glory of the children of my father's house, of my mother's house, I break you now. 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 In the name of Jesus. So the next one said, by fire, by force, I enter the warehouse. Right now, I'm going to enter that warehouse. That warehouse that I talked about earlier. You know, the Bible revelation I spoke about earlier. So I'm going to enter that warehouse now and collect your possessions. Collect your things. Collect your husband. Collect your children. Collect your cars, your house. Whatever they have locked in that warehouse. This is your time. This is your minute that you're going to collect it. I'm going to leave it for 2 minutes so that you will collect it in the mighty name of Jesus. By the power of the Almighty God, it's not me that is doing it. It's Almighty God that is doing it. So we're going to pray. By fire, by force, I enter the warehouse where my enemies have kept my benefits. You know what they have kept in your life. Begin to pray right now that you have entered there with the fire of the Holy Ghost, that you are claiming them back. Begin to claim your possession. Begin to claim it now. Claim it now. Every evil warehouse, they have locked my destinies. They have locked my children, my spouse, my promotion, my house, my cars. I take it back now. I take it back now by the mercy of God. I take it back now by the mercy of God. I take it back now by the mercy of God. I take it back now. I enter the warehouse now. Begin to say it. Wherever you are, distance is not a barrier. Holy Spirit will touch you wherever you are right now. Say, I take it now. I enter now and I take all my things now by fire, by force. Whatever the enemy has taken from me by force, whatever they have taken to me and locked it in a warehouse. Father, Lord, with that key of house of David, I break that warehouse. I collect my possession. I collect my inheritance in the mighty name of Jesus. You need to collect it now. Begin to collect it now. Whatever that belongs to you that they have locked down. Oh, Father, Makaraba, Seti Robo Seti, Makiraba, Setaraba, power of the Holy Ghost, move, power of the Holy Ghost, move. Any warehouse they have locked down, every one possession here, any of their dominion here, Holy Spirit, locator. Locate it, deliver it to them, Lord. Father, Lord, we beg you, deliver it to them, Lord. That satanic house, that satanic warehouse, they have locked down their possessions, they have locked down good things that is coming to them. Holy Spirit, break it. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, Lord, break that satanic warehouse. Holy Spirit, break that satanic warehouse wherever they have locked down anyone destiny here, wherever they have locked their possessions, wherever they have locked their benefits, wherever they have locked their inheritance, wherever they have locked their children, wherever they lock everything that God has given them, Father Lord, break it. Father Lord, as they enter spiritually, oh my God, Father Lord, let them collect every other possessions they have put there, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Power of the Holy Ghost, locate them. Power of the Holy Ghost, locate them. Locate them. Open that warehouse in the mighty name of Jesus. Every spiritual guard they have used to guard that, to be guarding that house, I command them now to receive fire. I command them now to be electrocuted. I command them now to receive fire. I command them to be electrocuted in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray, because if you don't pray hard, your spirit man cannot enter. If like them, you see, when that pray, this in that pray that breakthrough did not come to him. He was still on his knees, was praying. So you have to pray so that your spirit man will go there, so that no power will hold you down there, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, open that gate. Father Lord, open that warehouse. Father Lord, open that warehouse. Let them begin to possess their possession. Let them begin to collect their inheritance, in the mighty name of Jesus. I command every spiritual guard to receive fire. Receive fire now. Receive fire now. Receive fire now. Receive fire now. Every spiritual gate man, they have put in that warehouse, receive fire, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, everlasting Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We're going to pray. Say, I send the thunder of God to the warehouse where the enemies have kept my family with sickness. You know, some people, some family, you know, they are just sick, sick, sick. Different things is happening. You know, that sickness will not go away because they have locked it down. They send it. We're going to send their miseries one by one. So, oh Lord, with your thunder of fire, go to the warehouse where the enemies have kept my family with sickness. You know, some family, they have those kind of sickness that is going on in that family that never enter. Continue to expand, continue to expand. So that barrier, we're going to break it today in the mighty name of Jesus. We're going to break it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, every sickness they have locked down that they are opening and throwing to anyone's family here, Father, Lord, let it backfire to sender. Let it backfire to sender. Let it backfire to sender. Let it backfire to sender in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil sickness, every sickness that have a pattern, oh, Father, Lord, let it go back to sender. Let it go back to sender. Let it go to send that in the mighty name of Jesus. Anyone hurt they have locked on evil padlock here, because you are here today, I command that padlock now to be open. I command that padlock now to be open. I command that padlock to be open. Receive your healing. 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 Receive your healing now in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive your healing now in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive your healing now. Receive your healing now. Every padlock they have used to lock down your destiny, I command you now to receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. The next one, after this one, that is the last one. Say, any security agents of the evil assigned to monitor the doors of satanic warehouse, which we have said earlier, begin to command God now to release his fire on them, because those satanic agents that is there, those gates man, they are the problem that is not letting, because angels, they are just, we even, you know, we have power, you know, we can send the agents a message, you know, just like when Daniel angel was coming, that angel was arrested, you understand me? So we want to pray that your angel will not be arrested, your angel will lead your spirit man to go in and collect your things. So we're going to pray for that spiritual gate man right now that is guarding there in the mighty name of Jesus. Makarabo soto rebaba se tarabaye. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, every security agent, evil security agent, We release the fire of God upon them. We release the fire of God upon them. We release the fire of God upon them. Begin to release fire upon them right now. Every security agent, every gate man that is not letting you get your access of your possession, receive fire, 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 receive fire of the Holy Ghost, 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 spiritual gate man, spiritual monitoring of my possessions. I command you now to receive permanent blindness, receive permanent blindness. Every spiritual gate man that is running up and down, that is monitoring everything, oh Father Lord, let them receive permanent blindness, let them receive permanent blindness right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, release your fire, release your fire, release your lake of fire upon them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. So the last one, you're going to pray this one. So everything that has been locked in my life, I unlock it now in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, as the Bible says, whatever that has been locked, you know, whatever that have been locked in heaven is still going to be locked on earth. Whatever have you opened there, we open here. Those are the Bible verse that have been reading since. So we want to pray everything that have been locked in my life, I command it not to be unlocked in heaven, unlocked now in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that have been locked in my life, I command you now to be open. I command you now to be open in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that have been locked in my life, be open. Be open in the mighty name of Jesus. Be open in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that have been locked in my life, be open. Be open. Be open. Be open in the mighty name of Jesus. Be open. Be open. Anything that have been locked in my life, be open in Jesus' name. We pray, amen. So I just want to talk about that. How for you, like people that are going around and everywhere to be looking for how this padlock is going to be open. Remember earlier I said when five, for example, they lock somebody down with seven padlocks. When you open one, you go and meet the pastor, they open one for you. You did not open, no, the pastor said they have opened it. You go there with one padlock, they have opened it. This is how you're going to do it. You understand me? So you have to give way for the Holy Spirit to open it for you. Holy Spirit is the only one that have the key. It's not me. It's not you. You understand me? Like I said, for example, that if they lock somebody down, like seven, is a completion and a perfection. You understand me? But devil now come and revise it. So when they lock this person down with seven padlock, because alphabet numbers is very, very important in the Bible and the spiritual ring. So when they are locking those padlocks, they will know that, okay, it's 5-1 to lock or 3-1 to lock. For example, like I said earlier, if they lock the person with 5 padlock, that means they have taken the grace and God's goodness away from that person. That person will never get locked. That person will never get God's grace, because number 5 in a God's kingdom is grace and goodness and favor. That is what number 5 meant. But Satan and I change it. So okay, mama, just let unlock this person up with 5. That's where people, they don't receive favor, they don't receive goodness. You understand me? Like the people they lock with 7, they, you know, the 7 means completeness and perfection. That is where you see that those people, they are doing things half. So if we begin to talk about numbers today, we're not going to live here. I just want to repeat that again. In case when you have dreamt of numbers, you don't know what the numbers means, you can tell me. You can write me on Facebook or WhatsApp or call me. Then I will tell you what those numbers means. So why I'm repeating this today is for you to know what numbers mean. So if you dream and see any number, you have to take it seriously, because number is very, very important in the Bible and in the spiritual world. And God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Like I said, today is day 13 of our 40 days fasting, and tomorrow is day 14. I think I will come online tomorrow, and God will surely bless you all. We're going to go to another session of prayer tomorrow. God will surely bless you as you have come to this line today. I really appreciate you as you are blessing us and pray for us. God will surely bless you. And don't forget that we are always praying for you. This is a prayer ministry. When we say we will pray for you, we pray for you. A lot of people here that have come, they have seen what God has done for them in a very few days. It's not a pray, because when something, your case is urgent, you bring it, we pray what we call intensive prayer. So when we pray the intensive prayer, we pray it and God will surely get your attention and everything will surely come pass in your life. Uh-huh. So we are intercessors ministry. So we love prayers. That is what we are here to do. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter your location. We have pastors everywhere around, around everywhere, around the globe. And they will surely pray for you where you are. God will surely reach you where you are. So don't say because I'm in Canada, you are in Nigeria. I have pastors in Nigeria. I have in Ghana. I have in everywhere because we are doing a prayer chain. So if you require to do a prayer chain for you, we will do it for you. And God will surely bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. So I'm going to post it out when I'm going to be online tomorrow. And that's it. And if you have any prayer, I see that some people were trying to call. Maybe they left now. So if you still have any prayer, you can still wait or text me or WhatsApp. I can still pray with you. If your case is urgent, I will pray with you. And God will surely bless you in the name of Jesus. I'm your friend and humble Sister Dora. And God will surely bless you. Please share this video. And, if you know you have not given your life to God, give your life to God today. Don't let Satan trick you that you will not be saved. The only sin that Holy Spirit don't forgive is when you blaspheme against the Holy Spirit. Because when you blaspheme against the Holy Spirit, as Holy Spirit said, as God said in the Bible, He said that sin is not going to be forgiven. But whatever thing that you have done and devil is using it to blackmail you, it's time to tell devil, hey, I won't do this anymore. I am going to give my life to God. And God is waiting to receive you warmly with His own hands. And when you do that, you see everything that we have been talking today, we have been preaching today, because it's only God that have the key that is going to open that door for you. I don't have that key. I'm just intercessor. I'm just a servant of God that is giving you the word, what God has given me. So when you come to God's kingdom, cross from this side to the other side, you will see that things will begin to good for you. Things you will begin to manifest. It's going to open the doors of greatness, God, the doors of everything that they have shut against you. If you really look at some people's life, their doors of greatness have really shut down. But there are some prayers that you will pray, you will start to manifest. Things will begin to happen in your life. That is how God works. That is when you know that God is going to do it. But if you are not too sure, you are not too sure that God is going to do it for you, He's not going to do it. Because when you are sure, you are moving the right hand of God, which is power. Remember when that man came, that soldier came to meet Jesus Christ, that his servant is sick. Then Jesus Christ will say, let me go with you. He said, no, you don't need to go with me. Just say that word. When you say that word, my servant is going to be well. Then Jesus just said the word, and that servant was well when he get home. When he left, Jesus looked at his disciples and said, I have never seen this kind of faith in Israel. So it's faith that is moving the mountain. Without faith, you cannot move the mountain. Without faith, that storm that you feel that is there for a long time will never go away. So when devil, me, I use it to praise God all the time. And then one pastor is saying, I learned one thing from you, Sister Dora. When something happens, you just be, oh, I thank you, God. I thank you, God. Yes, I do it, because even the day my house burned down for you, oh, God, thank you. Father, Lord, I thank you. I thank you. Then it will now reverse to your blessing. Then when something happens, you start crying and all those things. When you are crying, you are enjoying your future. And when you cry, the wall will break and serpents will enter. You understand me? So that cry, when the Bible says with everything you have to praise God, the reason is that when you are praising God, fire will be burning them. But when you are crying, they will be celebrating that cry. That is their blessing. Your cry is the blessing for them over there. I use it to make parable all the time, and I stand by my words. When devil cut this hand, I will use this hand to praise God. It doesn't matter when I enter heaven with one eye. It doesn't matter. When I go there, I know that Almighty God is going to restore everything back to me. As I'm talking to myself, I'm talking to you. I just want to congratulate you. as you have given your life to God today, no matter what, don't be thinking about all those things, material things and all those things. It's God that is going to give you whatever you need. You understand me? As you are praising Him, you love Him. When you are in the presence of the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit will give you the thing you know that you don't need. And there is nothing God cannot do. I'm telling people, there is nothing God cannot do. He is the one that will do everything that you don't expect. He's the one that is going to break every chain. He's the one that is going to make your life beautiful. He's the one that is going to change your level. So, you know, with everything that is going on around the world, a lot of wrong prophecies and everything, when you read your Bible, everything that I'm telling you here, see, go and read it in the Bible. And when you read the Bible, you know, when I'm reading the Bible, I see a lot of prayers in the Bible. When I'm reading the Bible, that's where I'm collecting most of my prayers. You see that, oh, this thing is really happening. This thing is really happening. I'm just talking this one out of the preaching that I preach today, because I love you all. I want you to prepare yourself for Christ. I want you to receive this inheritance. Because some people, they think that they are rich. They are not even rich. Like I said all the time, if, for example, your inheritance is $300 million, and you are just dancing with $100,000. You see that inheritance, you are not there yet. And I pray that God will open the eyes of your understanding, and in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray that spirit of it doesn't matter, God will take it away from your life. God, the people's problem here in this abroad is the spirit of it doesn't matter. They don't feel that there are spiritual things. There are spiritual things that have been working. So you just look yourself, look around and see what has been happening in your life. You know that there is a problem. You understand me? And that problem, you have to tackle it now. Why are you going to tackle it? You're going to tackle it with God, believing that God is going to do it for you. So when you stop talking your problem more than the way you pray, God is not going to listen. God don't listen to sentiment prayer. They don't look at how you are saying it. When you are serious, then God will surely listen to you in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray for you all here now, that whatever prayer that you have been praying for years, that Almighty God will answer you today in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that has been expanding your problem because you don't know, out of ignorance, I pray that Almighty God will open your eyes today in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that you will have an encounter with the Holy Spirit today in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that you will receive that divine touch that will change your life, that will change things around for you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that heaven will get your attention today. I pray that heaven will get your attention today. I pray that heaven will get your attention today. I pray that heaven will get your attention today in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that have locked down your access, every power that have locked down everything that God has given to you, I command them right now to release it in the mighty name of Jesus, because they don't have a choice. We are not negotiating. We are praying with the power of the Holy Spirit, with the strength of God. That's where we are praying. I command them now to release it. I command them to release it. I command them to release it. Wherever your destiny has been locked down, your destiny of your children, anything that has been locked down in your life that is not moving for you, but because you are here today, those things will begin to move. I say those things will begin to move. Those things will begin to move for you. It will begin to move for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God will surely bless you, and God will bless you. So I will see you tomorrow in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm coming online tomorrow with another prophetic word from the Holy Spirit. I will be here tomorrow. I will post the time that I will be here tomorrow, and God will surely bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye.